Hello everyone, my name is Brian and welcome to another Smite request, and this time around we will be playing the Loki. It was an either Clash or Conquest, and I don't really feel like playing Conquest, not with Loki at least. It's not really one of the gods I want to play there. You'll be stuck in the solo lane farming up, and you'll just be that split push Loki or that one that tries to one shot everyone on your opponent team. That's probably the playstyle I would go for. But I don't really feel like we will make it to late game if I'm just farming the entire game. Anyway, so we'll be playing Loki in a clash. As you may or may not have noticed, I'm God rank 9 Loki. I didn't even know I was that high with him because I haven't played him in a very long time. He is an interesting god. Everyone hates playing against him. And I'm not gonna lie, I'm not too fond of playing him myself. I don't know, it's just not really... Ooh, nice, I got it. I actually got it with the decoy. I used my decoy to pull the buff towards us. Even though they had the aggro, the decoy was able to pull it. And interestingly enough, we got the kill on that. But as you can probably tell already, we have... Oh, well, that starts off very well. Hitting basic attack, very difficult. But yeah, it starts off well. We are against the ultimate... slap or damage team. They don't really have any frontline at all. They have one assassin, three mages, and a hunter, which all of them can do a lot of damage. We do have a frontliner. We have our Ganesha, the new god. I will try out Ganesha in a while, or when I have an opportunity to. It is an interesting one. It is literally the... I think that he's probably the most supporty guardian in existence, since he doesn't get any kills when someone is around. Which is kind of interesting. Really interesting the way they did that. Kind of like it though. It brings something new to the table. And he does get increased range on his assist. So that's not bad at all. Looks like our Ganesha is hit. Unfortunately enough, dies to the bleed. Let's see if we can go for some damage. Abon might go for the ultimate. I still have my Sanctuary. So ooh, he goes for ultimate on the Scylla. I think... Oh, she's dead. Luckily enough. Come on. I had to use my ultimate there to get away. At least I'm able to survive. They did use a couple of ultimates. They used the Hopwa ultimate on the Scylla and the Hoji ultimate. And Aurelius used her ultimate onto me. Nice knockup by her though. I was a little bit too worried. They do have a couple of knockups, so that's a little bit annoying. Kokokan ultimate has a knockup. The leap in by the Hoji has a knockup. Aurelius herself has a knockup. And of course the Hopwa, probably the easiest knockup in their team. Pretty annoying to deal with. But... for now, we're going to just farm up. Since we are down a bit, and I feel like we have better of a late game comp than an early game comp, even though we do have the Thanatos, I'd rather go for a little bit more, or an easier way of farming, than going for a lot of damage on my 3 or my 1. So I'm leveling up my 2. As you can see, it already clears the Archer minions, and I won't put any more points into this. Clearing the Archer minions is fine enough by me. That way I can just focus on more damage now. So yeah, farm up a little bit more important, but they also have good late game gods. Ah, I didn't put it in range. That sucks. I tried to pull it again with my 2. That's unfortunate. That's fine though. If I pull it with my 2, then the Hoyi couldn't have gotten the triple bounce. So that's why I did it. Or at least tried to go for it. Just pop down that decoy. Some damage. Knock up by the Abois again. Probably something that will happen a lot this game. Luckily enough, the Wheelish isn't around that much. I think she's thick. Or she's stuck to the right side a little bit more. Ooh. Looks like she like got pulled by the Wheelish ultimate. I think she used the 3 and got pulled under the ground. That's something that you can do as a Wheelish. Pull the escape from Scylla, Hades. Those awkward ones. To avoid the ultimate. Very low on HP. Use the minion wave to at least try and block the one from the Kokokan. And Ganesha has turned up to at least provide some peel for me. And I will be able to get out. I'll go for Transcendence first since I'm just farming up a little bit. It also gives me more mana so I can use my abilities a lot more often. Which is not a bad thing at all. After that I'll go for full cooldown or close to full cooldown reduction. I'll go for a brawler. No, not a brawler. Well, maybe. Depends on if they get a lot of lifesteal. But I will go for a Jotun's Wrath first, then I'll probably go for a, what's it called? Hydra's Lament. So I'll have 30% CDR. After that, I can go for... Oh, that's so annoying. I can go invisible. Need to be a little bit careful. Though he knows where I am. Nice knockup. I might... Yeah, I need to ult. It's an ult for an ult. Still not something I would like to do. Because I have only used my ultimate yet to get away. Probably shouldn't have engaged onto the OE, since he can just see me with that mark on me. It's kind of an annoying counter matchup. Once I'm marked, I'm just visible for him. Doesn't matter what I do. But it's still an ult for an ult, so I guess it's completely fine. As long as I don't give up too much as for kills. I mean, we're only down 3 kills so far, which is not bad considering the situation. I mean, Kurnos isn't back, or he is just not connecting anymore. I can tell you already, he's not coming back anytime soon. At all. Okay. Ooh. Ultimate by the Abois. We might be able to get the Abois here. Sanctuary by the Abois. Let's see if we can use the 2 to do some damage. Maybe he steps into it. He actually did step into it. Fortunately enough, our Thanatos is able to finish it off. It didn't do enough damage to finish off the Abois, my decoy. Was very close, not gonna lie. Let's just use decoy quickly to clear this. I can try to help. They're just way too deep. I mean, if everyone on our team is alive and pretty healthy, then okay. But I think that we were a little bit too low on HP. But it looks like Thanatos got out. Wow. Really? Not sure how he got out, not gonna lie. He was surrounded by the opponents. He doesn't even have full boots yet. He only has boots too. He has increased movement speed with his 2, of course, but... interesting. That's fine though, not gonna lie. It's completely fine by me. Kind of annoying. Trying to dodge. He can see me, so... That damage is so annoying. Let's see if we can return some of it. Ooh, that damage. He leaps back into it. He will take some damage from the tower. They might try to dive me here. Actually, I don't think they will. I'll just head back again. This game has been... complete backfest. Bit unfortunate though. It cost me my relic as well as my ultimate for just his ultimate. It will be down though. It's a big ultimate. Can be pretty annoying to deal with. Although I feel like we have pretty good team comp to deal with that. We have the dash and the Kanisha who can get out of the ultimate pretty easily. Zilla has a leap, of course, or a sentinel. Thanatos has slow immunity and I have slow immunity on an ability. I have it on my invisibility, and the Thanatos has it on his 2. So we aren't too worried about the Hui ultimate, but it's still a good amount of damage and a huge area of effect. More of a teamfight ultimate than my ultimate ever will be, that's for sure. Unless, of course, I can get someone out of the teamfight immediately, then mine is pretty good. Okay, I picked up Sunder. I don't really feel like I need the Purification Beads. I know they have a Bois and an Awilish, but... I don't know, I'm not feeling it. I don't want to get Purification Beads just for the Awilish and the stun for the Hoi. Let's see if we can go for some damage. Stab her in the back a little bit. Get some bleed onto her. You can go... Ooh, nice. Let's see if we can go for the Kukulkan. No! Was able to... Dang it. Nice Sanctuary by the Kukulkan. Able to avoid not only my 3 with my basic attack, but also my Sunder. And that's actually... Very unfortunate, and I'm almost 100% sure he would have died. Need to be a little bit careful here. Not sure how I got that. Oh, never mind. I was like, I don't get... Oh, that damage. I don't really get why I got that kill, but then I realized, oh wait, we have a Ganesha. Ganesha actually got that kill. I was the closest one nearby. Got the kill for that. That's actually pretty cool. It's actually pretty cool, because... If you have effects that benefit you when you kill, like for instance Bloodforge passive, which the Thanatos did pick up, or Kali target pickup, then that means that you will get that, well, yeah, benefit, so the shield or the regen or whatever, when Ganesha gets the kill. It's actually pretty interesting. Of course, if it goes to the right target. The closest to Ganesha gets the kill. So if someone else is close to Ganesha, you won't be able to get the kill. I can try and go for the Kukulkan here. He's pretty fast though. Abois here as well. Never mind. Okay. Never mind that too. facing the Wheelish just in case she will go for that. Ooh, look at that juicy wave. Oh, all that gold. Golden experience. Mmm. So good. Come on. Yeah, the bleed is enough. Let's just use Sanctuary to try and survive here. Come on. Nice, able to survive. Thanatos, not so lucky though. Still a 1-for-1. This might go and go more aggressive on me. I don't think he'll find me. Nah. He doesn't stay. It's quite risky for him as well to stay. I didn't really want to go in because one ability will probably kill me. And he didn't want to stay in because, well, one basic attack with my 3 probably kills him as well. But yeah, by the way, if you level your 1 first, you'll do more damage in total. But sometimes I really like to just keep that a little bit as an escape. So I don't want to rely on my 1 or just my 1 for the additional damage. Also, you can proc your... Okay, that was a pretty good bounce. Not gonna lie. But yeah, you can also proc your 3 way earlier. It will stick onto you. Yeah, slow immunity. Love it. But it will stick onto you for a bit. So you can almost instantly refresh your 3 once you use it at the end of the duration. If you have a good amount of cooldown reduction, that is. So you can get your 3 off 2 times if you play it correctly. I haven't played Loki long enough. Or I haven't played him in a while. So I don't think I'll get that out too often. But it's definitely something that's possible. And I just like the burst damage instead of the potential to give them Sanctuary or heal or whatever. Or talk about heal. Beats and Sanctuary use there. Trying to avoid the Abois. But yeah. There was actually, that was not only his Aegis, I think. I think it was his Puri as well, if I remember the sound correctly. Which is pretty good. But fortunately had to die for it. Nice pickup. Good damage. Fortunate ultimate. I don't think it would have been enough. Come on. Nice pickup. If that ultimate from Ganesha was on point, I think Wheelish would have died or forced to jump. Not sure if she had her jump, actually. That's fine, though. Ganesha is interesting. I didn't read it too well. Not sure what a 1 provided. I know it does damage just in a straight line, but I think it provided additional damage for us as well, depending on how many guards or minions got hit. But that's pretty good. The 3 is a dash. If you hit the opponent, then they will be stunned for a bit and knocked up. Let's see if you can go for the Kukulkan. Come on. Okay, reach it. Wow, Kukulkan is so fast. I don't want to die, I'm too young. That knockup was very good, by the way. Not only put me in an awkward spot, but also, it put me in an awkward spot and it pushed me into the tower. Invisibility. Not sure why the Abois does so little damage. Actually, I think it was because of the Ganesha Silence. That second ability provides protection around the Ganesha. So, I think that was what it was, because the Abois, Abois doesn't have a lot of power items. He has the Warlock Sash, which is pretty expensive. He also has the Chronos Pendant, which is pretty expensive. And don't provide as much power as other options. So, yeah. I think that's one of the reasons. But the protections definitely helped me out. I think I would have died if he didn't give me those protections. Let's avoid the Tornado. I still feel like the Tornado should apply it sooner. Because it's just... It's just, it provides, it hits so late. Oh, that sound was so bad. I wanted to go on to the Abois. I know the Abois has the Warlock Sash, but I feel like if I Sunder him and combo him with all my abilities, he will definitely die. Thanatos in a little bit of a good spot. Kukulkan ultimate used there. Way off the mark. Abois goes very aggressive. Definitely want to help out. Do need to be a little bit careful though. I do with my ultimate still up. Let's go for the Abois. Let's use Sanctuary. Please. Ooh, I literally had 1 HP. Not even close. Not even close. Not even close at all. Damn, that was very, very close. Shit my pants. That was so close. If I didn't have the slow immunity on my 1, I was just straight up dead. Luckily enough, did we? Oh no, we didn't. I thought, didn't we? Did or did we not pick up the Yabua? I don't think we did, otherwise he would not have been alive yet. Unfortunate. Yabua is very low. Looks like a Wheelish will die though. Nice cripple by the Scylla to secure that one, otherwise you can just hop into Suku, get away immediately. Don't really want to go aggressive on the Yabua on my own. I don't think I can kill him without my ultimate. Or I need to go invisible and hit him with my abilities and get out without being damaged too much. Then I'll have an opportunity. Oop. Almost stepped into that one. Visibility not lasting long enough. Still goes for the knockup. 321. That's not a lot of damage. I don't like his build. He's not dealing as much damage as he should be. He should probably hit me for... nice bounce. Need to get out. Still have my invisibility, but though he can still see me with his mark on me. Maybe he should have ulted. Maybe he should have ulted the up water. Oh, he still dies. Okay, that's completely fine. He went very greedy to try and go for me. I think he wanted to knock me up, but he didn't have it up. I knew it at least. But he did have his Cronus pendant, so it would be up pretty soon. Come on. Yeah, look at that damage. Sunder. Definitely hurting a lot. Kukulkan wanted to go for ultimate, so I'll just back off a little bit. Looks like Thanatos is able to pick that one up. Nice damage. Oh, that knockup was very good on the Wheelish. I couldn't really turn around to avoid it either, because then the Hoji ultimate would have killed me. So I had to choose. I had no other choice. After I engaged onto the Wheelish with that Hoji ultimate in play. That's fine though. We are able to trade 1 for 4, which is very good considering it's still a 4v5. But that's something that I like to do, or like to think, that when I miss one player of our team, I usually imagine that he's just the feeder of the team, so that we'll have a better opportunity without him. Sometimes that's true. I feel like this might actually be one of those cases where that would have been true. But it's still difficult to deal with one less player. It's still one player less to have abilities, to have ultimates, to be around, to distract them. But yeah, this is also one less player to feed. I don't know. No, he is definitely the issue here. He can deal a lot of damage, or he has been doing a lot of damage, and he hasn't died yet. So getting rid of him is pretty important, and probably pretty difficult as well. Luckily enough, I can just clear, or passively clear the wave by just throwing out my two, get most experience and gold for that. Actually got all of it, and I can just head back into the jungle, kind of make sure that I don't get seen all the time. But Abua definitely hurting a lot at the moment. Thanatos hit by the Kokon ultimate, didn't hit as much. Not sure how the Kokon is built, but that's fine though. Oh no! Oh, that is so bad. That sucks. If I actually hit the basic attack before I ulted him, he would have died there, because it would have been one additional basic attack to hit him with. And I missed my Sunder because he used his ultimate. He did use his beads there to use his ultimate before the stun wore off, I think. Otherwise, he probably would not have been able to use it in time. Unfortunate. Yeah, fifth item. I picked up the... Why do I always get the name? I picked up the Crusher. I don't want to get any more cooldown reduction, because there aren't any good cooldown reduction items anymore that don't provide, or that provide you with power. And that's something that I really want to get at the moment. A lot of power. Power and penetration. It also provides me 15 penetration, which is very, very good. Engagement onto the Abua will fall down. I think the Ganesha got the kill, but the credit went to the Scylla with that ultimate. I'm not sure how much damage it does. It is the old Noir ultimate, where you put down a dome and every single time you pass through it, you'll just take damage. So you can go over the wall. Yes! Nice pickup. Apoish definitely will die here. Yes! Nice. Two pickups. Definitely in our favor. A 1-4-3 so far. Nice. Able to go over the wall, hitting that Oji, definitely very important. If he was out of range, it would have been a very awkward one. I think he would have survived then. I think I can solo the Wheelish pretty easily. Oh, she uses her ultimate. That's very good. I'll just go away for a little bit. Actually, with Scylla we can definitely get her. Ah, Wheelish knows that as well. Good escape path by the Wheelish. If she went towards her Phoenix, she would have died because of me. Because I was still lurking around there. And she was too fast with the Suku to get that going. Come on. Do you have your dash? No, Kanisha doesn't have dash. That's unfortunate. Come on. No, I missed my Sunder again. Whoa. Oh god, I wanted to use Sanctuary when the Abois wanted to use his one, but Kokokan ultimate over the wall hit me. Rough. Nice. Oh, look at that. That shield provided to the Thanatos was because the Ganesha got the kill with the one. That's actually a lot of fun. I think that makes Ganesha very good with gods that get a benefit. Like Thanatos, like Kali. Kali gets, well, when she gets a target, of course, regens 80% of her HP. And Thanatos, when he gets a kill, he also gets reduced cooldown and gets a good amount of healing. So you can get a lot out of that. And the Bloodforge, of course. Don't really feel like you're off very well by relying on it too much. Because Bloodforge is still very expensive. But I'm able to get it now fully. And I have a lot of power penetration and cooldown reduction. So I feel like with the Bloodforge, if I get a kill, I'll have that shield. I'll have that increased movement speed. Which will definitely be very useful. And with the Ganesha, the chance of me getting that shield is just way, way higher. See if we can go. Oh, that was very bad. Wow, look at that damage. Sanctuary well timed though. She will survive. We can go for the Kokokan here. He might die. The Sanctuary. Ah, oh, Kokokan didn't die. Oh boy, leave me alone. Okay, he's hurting now. I think he has finished his Rod of Duty. At least feels like it. He's definitely hurting me a lot. I played it pretty bad. Missed my ultimate. And after that, went maybe a little bit too aggressive on the Kokokan. That's fine though. Oh, aftermark. If that ultimate hit again, the Hobwa would have been screwed. Looks like. Come on. Can you get him? No, doesn't look like it. A Wheelish behind. Finding the Scylla. Use the Thorns. She has it. Hmm, interesting. Don't know if the Wheelish has any protections. Otherwise, I feel like Thorns not really worth it. Nice damage. Whoa. I want to say nice damage onto the Hobwa with that Scylla Sikkim. Or a Crush, I mean. But then that Oyi bounce came through and literally two shots. Literally two shot the Scylla there. Wow. Kind of surprised by that damage. I was thinking about upgrading my Sanctuary, but it's still down for more than 1.5 minutes. So I'll just go for the Power Potion. I'll at least have that. I'll grab the Mana Buff, have the full cooldown... Words. I have the full cooldown reduction with that. And that will help me out, especially since I have my ultimate. I can't really contest this as well. Tornado is there. I do want to try at least contest it. I can go for an ultimate if I have... Oh, he's so dead. Nice. Should be able to get out here. Slow immunity will help out. Take a good amount of damage though. Decoy, just in case they have... Actually, they don't have any ranged damage. Except for the basic attacks from the three mages that can be blocked by that decoy. Since the hunter already died. But that's fine though. I can get the Sanctuary now. And that additional damage from the potion definitely helped me out there. And the fact that I got the kill provide me with that shield. Actually, I have top damage. Interesting. To be fair, they're all not as tanky. And I'm probably... It's easier for me to get close to them than for the Scylla. Looks like the Apoise knew I was there. Decent damage. Let's see if we can avoid the ultimate. No! Oh, I thought he was going way more in the middle. Damn, that was way too close again. At least I survived and that was Kokokan ultimate. Not went the way I wanted it to though. Actually, I don't think it's a smart idea to buy that potion already. Because if I get a lot of gold, I might be able to get a 3000 gold power potion. And that's way more valuable than the 500 for a longer duration. And I still have it for more than 3 minutes, so... Let's see... Oh, we can definitely get Abois. Goodbye, Abois, you will be missed. Invisibility, you can go for the Oyi. Looks like he uses escape already. 2 kills, very quick pickup with that Bloodforge. I have so much additional movement speed, he couldn't get away. Nice pickup onto the Kokokan. And... How did he get it? What? Sunder? Does he have Sunder? Not sure. I didn't see him use any abilities. Oh, well, it's fine though. We can go for a Phoenix. Actually, we can end. They are dead for such a long time. 25 seconds onto the Abois. The Wheelish is the only one left alive. We are all quite healthy. Thanatos is the lowest on the team because he is tanking the Phoenix for a bit, but not bad at all. I definitely think we can get this Titan. With so much damage. And if we can get that Wheelish, you can't really do a lot either. Nice shell, by the way, by Oganisha. Making sure that we don't take as much damage from the Wheelish. And that is going to be it. The 4v5 victory. Okay, when we started, I didn't think this would happen. Definitely nice one. Was glad I was able to pick up that Awad though. He's been such an annoying part of the fight. Once he uses his ultimate onto someone, he will straight up half hit them and kill them afterwards, or someone else will kill them, or forces out sanctuaries or whatever. Just very annoying to deal with. And being able to... I'll just give it a 5. I don't even care. I mean, the game just knew that the current nose wouldn't come, so we had a very even game. 4v5. Yeah, that was a lot of fun. I definitely feel like it was the right choice to farm up in the early game a little bit more, because with the way they... well, just the fact that they are with the 5 of them, of course, and their early game damage is pretty good also, because of the... Well, Hubwa always deals a lot of damage. The Wheelish 2 does an immense amount of damage early game. Upwash does a lot of damage all the game. Korkan can do a lot of damage with his ultimate. OU has been dealing a lot of damage the entire game. Just a little bit too risky. So I really wanted to farm up. And we didn't have the best clear. Ganesha doesn't have great clear. Thanatos doesn't have great clear. The only one with good clear is Scylla. And that's not something that will happen immediately. She needs to have at least, I think, 3 or 4 points into her 2 to properly clear a wave. So by leveling up my 2, I was able to clear the wave on my own. That way farm up a good amount. Able to get a lot of items going. And I feel like this is probably the best build I could have gone for. With the Crusher, I was able to get more cooldowns off because of that reduction of 1 second once you use a basic attack on an opponent. And of course, penetration and power, never a bad thing. A little bit of attack speed. I was thinking about going for the Brawlers at that stage, but though he didn't have any lifesteal yet. And other than that, they didn't have any lifesteal at all. The only one that could heal was the Upwash by picking up his corpses. And I wasn't too worried about that. So I didn't go for the Brawlers for the healing reduction. And I think that actually worked out pretty well. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. If you have another request, please let me know down in the comments. And as always, good luck, have fun, and I'll see you guys in the next one.